texture of this grass by adding in even a little bit lighter areas. Alright, so I got a lot of that. Alright, so now we're about to the point where I can start adding in the couple little things that we haven't worked on yet. And even though I might stop this video in just a second, I might do a lot more to this painting. You never know. I might come back tomorrow. That's a great thing with working with oils. Is I can come back to this thing tomorrow and work on it. Now, if I was painting flat with acrylic, I could too, but I wouldn't be getting the texture that I am out of this if I had acrylic. Now, you could use mediums with acrylic to give it texture, but it doesn't do the same thing that I'm doing here. You're not going to get this bouncing effect that you can, and it pulls it, and it's sticky. The oil, the petroleum, or whatever it is they put in there, that oil grabs each color. And doesn't want to let it go. All right, so I need to add a few tree barks, tree limbs, trunks, a few here and there, just so we're not too confused about what it is we're looking at. So I'm gonna put one here, and I'm using this Persian blue. What I do usually is I'll take a clean knife and I might just corner off little sections here that I might want to add some limbs to. Then I can go back to that Persian blue, very dark color. And I love using the palette knife for limbs because it's very uncontrollable, I guess you could say. Sometimes you have some big surprises. Sometimes it's not the surprise you want. Now, if the limbs are far away, you don't even have to come back in here with anything dark to show limbs. Let me fix this so you can see that a little bit better, maybe. And see, it's hard to see even if you see where I put it, it's hard to see where those limbs are. until I add the highlight of the sun reflecting off of it. So, I got this very light brown that I've mixed up. And I'm using the side of my knife with the paint just on the side. Never just use one tint of that color. I'll come back with some other tints. So now I'm adding some white to that same color to make it even lighter. And I'll just hit in a little spot. What I'm doing is I'm creating that contrast with that dark blue and those lighter browns so you can see there is a tree there. Now, you might make too many lines. Say, let's just say you wanted to cover up some. With this, it's very easy. You just go back and you might want to cover up half that limb because it's oil paint and it pulls right over the top of the color. You don't want. All right, so there's that one, and I'll probably put one here. This blue. as I go back, I barely make any marks at all. You actually just make it with your knife and it'll pull the paint and make it look like a limb there. All right, so that's those. So let's put some over here on this yellow. So because we're dealing with yellow, I'm not going to use a lot of blue over here. Everything will be turning green. And let's have our tree come. So. I wonder what you guys are doing for fun. Hopefully catching up on any work, right? Yeah, right. So I'm getting that right side of it, trunk, lightened up. That's where the sun would be reflecting off of what you can see there. Let's make a that hole right there. Tree. I want a perfect tree. Make our root system down here at the bottom. And we're going to cover up some of that. If you ever notice around a lot of the trees, the grass gets really, really light sometimes. Like little weeds and very light colored. Let's put some light colors here. That back side to be a little bit darker, so I'm gonna add a little bit of this blue. Yeah, there we go. Well, that'll work. Helps make that tree stand out a little bit better, doesn't it? Contrast always helps. If something just doesn't seem right to you, just add contrast. Alright. So I think I've gotten most of the limbs that I want to do done. Tree trunks. Some more of this. Alright, so now we're almost done. Almost. What we've got to do now is we've got to come up with a way to, let me do something else first. So now I want to come back and add some of these colors as fallen leaves here. No matter how weird that would look with those colors. We're just going to act like they're special trees. They have these little special attributes about them that help them to turn colors. It's far away, we're not going to see much, so we're not going to see really the purples. But we'll see the blues. And the best thing to do is use the tip of your knife. I have one that's actually bent that I normally use. Let me see if it's still here. Yep, it's here. Alright, so this one I bent slightly to be able to do just the edge of it. So I literally I scrape it at the tip like this. And that's all the paint that I'm going to get on there. And I'll just start making some little areas here of the blue. Make sure it doesn't get too muddy with the colors that are already on the canvas. Don't do all of them the same exact, you know, add different tones and even different blues. Right. Add some greens. Oh, I keep running out of green. Keep having to mix new green here. It's more of a meridian that I got here, but hey, let's try it. Didn't say it has to be all the same. But you definitely want to add, if you're going to use it down here, add a little bit in for continuity. So it makes sense to the eye that you're seeing that color, only you don't want it just in one spot. This is more of a sap green that I got going on here. And I always overlap them because the leaves would get pushed around. And some would wind up out here on the street or road. And now I'm coming to the lighter one. So what's the one thing y'all miss the most? Besides your art teacher, of course. Mine, I believe, besides some of my fantastic students, would have to be Starbucks. Just the convenience of not having to make my own coffee every day. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but sometimes you just don't feel like doing it. And y'all know I love my coffee. Got to grab some more tissue, and I'm so cramped in here to video, I can barely move. So I don't normally go out to eat much, so I'm not really missing a lot like that, but I do miss the option of being able to go and not have to clean up my own mess at home every time. All right, so now we gotta put these other colors over here. I like to usually start out with some of the darker ones. Start out with this Alzerian red. What we're doing is we're just sort of giving it the hint that some of these leaves have since fallen off. Now we have them up here in the grass. Always start far back and work your way up. That way you can work on the size because they're very tiny. Oh, that's too big. Far away, they should be very small, and it should get bigger as it comes back towards you. Some of them get blown around down the street, down the path, over to the other side. That's fine. You can put a couple over there. Same thing with the blues, you can bring those back over here. Greatest thing is when you're doing paintings, you know, there's a few rules that you want to know. The rest, just have fun with it. Yeah, I never realized how much toilet paper I'd use until this shortage thing happened. I had to cut back how much work I do because I only have so much of this really bad toilet paper to use. And I don't want to use the good stuff. So, it's actually, you would think Mr. Bauer being at home, he'd have more time for art. Actually, because of the toilet paper shortage, I've not been able to produce as much. Alright, so let's put some oranges. First, we'll do some of these dark oranges that are sort of brown. So this to me, what is my meaning behind this painting? This one sort of Mother Nature's version of my Christmas tree growing up. Those big, highly saturated, huge lights we used to have on our trees. Or I guess you would call them retro. We called them normal. But. Again, watch out for any patterns. If you do enough of this, there's no way you're even going to see a pattern. It's just going to be everywhere. You stay vigilant and just keep at this for maybe an hour or so. You really build up a lot of leaves here. All right. I could keep adding more and more on this. The hardest thing with art is trying to figure out when to stop.